Hello and welcome to Choice Testing. We are finally back here in Sweden after a long corona shutdown. We have not been allowed to come up here in Sweden, up in our cabin, all winter. And finally, almost summer, we are up here again. And it's lovely weather. It's lovely spring weather. You can hear the birds. It's 15 degrees. What's not to like? Today we're gonna try something new again. I have tried some axes and I'm not actually done with the axes. I have a couple of more brands that I want to test. But now I think it's time to test the saws, because saws is just as important as an axe, I think. Many people talk about what do you want, do you take a saw, do you take an axe? Well, it depends on what you have to do. I think that they are equally important. And actually, I would not know what to take if I was to choose from an axe or a saw, because I think they are just as important. But there are lots of very cool brands out there. Oh, there goes my dog. Of saws. And today we're going to start with one that I think most of you know, the Silky Saw. And I have actually two versions today to test. I have a Gumboy. I think most of you know this one. It comes in different sizes. This is one is the 300, but I'm gonna get back to that. And then the big Cantata Boy 500. Actually, those are for different types of work, but I'm gonna get back to that. Let's start with the Gumboy here. This is the 300 version, Gumboy 300, and it has it is the curved blade, as you can see here. Some facts about it: this is the 300 millimeter blade, folded it is 330 millimeters long, and unfolded it is 620. So almost more than double the size, and the weight is only 325. This is not a lot for a pretty large saw like this one. It has changeable blades, so the same handle can take different kind of saw teeth and sizes. This actually you can get in 210, 240, 270 and 300 millimeter blade. I think it is a cool blade. It has large teeth, 8 teeth per 30 millimeters, and this means that according to the Silky Saw, this is very good at fresh wood. So I think it's about that for it. It has a rubber, nice rubber handle here. It has a nice click system. As you can see here, it is locked down. You just press this one and it actually closes very fine down. This one is for around what you call them, tree trunks around this size. Something like 100 millimeters in diameters, and we're gonna go out and take a birch down with it and see how that feels and saw in a couple of logs with this saw. Okay, that's the Gumboy curved. Gonna try it out here later. Then we have the Silky Saw Cantata Boy 500, and this has a nice sheet with it, and it is, well, I think it's huge. It's a double-handed sword. No, not sword, it's a double-handed saw. And as you can see here, it is a large boy. We can see here, you have a nice screw here, that when it is screwed in here, you cannot open it or anything like that. You just have to unscrew it until it can't go any further. You push it down and you can see here you have a nice, and then you can screw it in again, and then you cannot close it either way. As you can see here, it is a two-handed saw and it is just a large saw. This is for trunks like this, or bigger. And I actually have a pine that has gone down in the storm down here that I'm gonna go down and saw in, so see how this works. This is of course for the larger campsite, the larger firewood making situation. So I'm gonna try this out. The specification for this one is that it is 500 millimeters, half a meter long. Folded it is 655, and unfolded it is 1175 millimeters long, a little bit over a meter, and the weight of it is 900 grams. I think that's about it for this Silky Boy. Yeah, you have a nice, very good quality sheath here, and there's actually also room for an extra blade in here if you would want that. So I think that's it about it. I think that the best way to, as you can see here, you screw it out, so now you are able to close it. See, there's actually an extra mechanism here when you're closing it, so if you have your hands here, you should not have your hands here because these are sharp as hell. There's an extra mechanism here, so you need to click it to close it all the way. Okay, let's go out and try it and see how they are. Okay, now as you can see here, we have found a birch that has been downweighted, we say in Danish, by snow. Then they, some of them gets like this when the weight of the snow gets too much for the birch, and this will never ever get up to stand again. It may actually live, but no need to. We have lots of birch here in the woods, so I'm gonna cut this down and make it for firewood. And as you can see here, this is a nice size for a gumboid 300 like this. Actually, it could take larger than this, but let's just see how it goes. We have the tree here, and I'm gonna go from here and then see how it is. Oh man! Actually, as you could see here, it went fast down because it was already bent. I'm just gonna get it under here. This is a very, very cool saw. I'm just gonna try to take out a nice piece of firewood here, like a half a meter or something like that. That's a big, big, good piece for a firewood. And as you can see here, it plows through. Very, very nice cut here, nothing at all. It's just as baby skins, as I would say. This is an excellent saw, and it makes an excellent job. And you can see a log like this, it would only take me 10 minutes, 20 minutes, half an hour, then I would have fine firework. Now this is fresh, of course, has to be laying down for a while, but you get the point. Excellent, excellent saw. I'm very impressed with the skills of this saw. Okay, let's now go down and to another tree I know that has been knocked down by the storm and try the big one. Okay, now I'm gonna prepare the container boy for this fella here. It's a big pine that has been knocked down in the woods, in the storm. And as you can see, I have already taken some of it because I needed a path through. But I'm gonna try this. Is, of course, I would normally use my motor saw on this, but with my Cantana Boy, I just had to try. I'm just gonna prepare it here, lock it down here. As you can see here, this is this would be too large for the Gun Boy, but let's try to see how this Cantana Boy will work on this. And I'm just gonna. Actually pretty fucking impressed. This did not take long at all. Take a look at the saw cuts here on this one. Excellent work. It almost didn't take much longer than the motor saw. Of course it did, but take a look at this. It cut beautiful. I'm just gonna have to try to make another cut. And, oh, take a look at these long strokes you can take with this saw. It's just amazing work. And the thing that you can have two-handed is just excellent. Take a look at it. Very nice cut. Very straight. This is just wonderful to work with. And as you can see here, 900 grams with you in the forest, and you can take down a large tree like this. It is just lovely to work with. I cannot say it better. Whoa.
You're in love?
This is great. It works great. You could make lots of firewood in no time with this. I'm impressed. Really I am. Yeah, I must say. This just plows through. Okay. Well, I think that's it about these two saws. I'm just gonna get the Gun Boy. I just put it over here. And of course, you could use the Gun Boy here to the smaller branches if you didn't want to use the large one. It could be fine on using on the small ones, but here you have two excellent outdoor saws. The small 300 millimeter can take nice big trunks down, but the Cantana Boy is the beast, and it's just lovely to work with. Both of them saws so beautifully and nice and steady, and I think they are just excellent saws. One thing I forgot is about the price of these guys. Well, they're not cheap. Most quality ain't. This one is 600 crowns. That's about 880 euros or something like that. This is 1600 crowns. Double of 160 euros or something like that. Maybe you can get them cheaper on sales or something like that. That was just what I saw on the net. But then again, then you also have a great quality saw. But until next time, see you later and enjoy the weather.